So recently I created a post on my community page on my YouTube, and a lot of you responded really positively about if you like this red neon effect. I pretty much put it on there to ask all if you would like to know how to do it. And it is something that's actually quite easy to do. So let's get started. The first thing you want to do is you want to get yourself an image of an animal or any type of image which you want to add a effect to. Once you've got yourself the image, you want to left click on it so it's a layer. And the very first thing is we need to crop the deer out itself. If you wanted to, you can use the magnetic lasso tool if you prefer that one, but I like to be a little bit more accurate, so I'm going to go with the pen tool, which is right here. They're both the same thing, but the pen tool is manual, so you are pretty much adding them yourself. If you don't know how to use the pen tool, it's really simple. All you do is left click once and then you left click again, and you can either hold it in or you can just click once and I'll give you a straight line. But most of the time, to go around the curves, you left click and drag the left side of the mouse. It is going around the curve right there. So the next one, I'm going to add it right here. And every time you do create a curve, you also need to hold Alt and then click on the point one more time. And this is pretty much to stop the line from automatically creating another one. For example, if I create a curved line here and left click again, it will create another one the same. So pretty much you want to try your best to get the edges only and just go around the object. If you wanted to zoom in, you can use the zoom tool, which is right here, or you can hold Alt and use the scroll wheel to go up. And this will allow you to zoom into your image. Okay, so for the rest of it, we don't really need the legs where the grass is. So what I'm going to do is I'm pretty much going to only select the under bit right here. So this is the only bit that I really need. Now, I'm probably going to also go a little bit above, so I still have some area if I do want to like use the eraser tool. All right, so now that you're pretty much back to the first one, all you got to do is left click on it and this will connect all your points up. So once you've connected all your points, then you want to go to selection and set it to zero, then press OK. Press Control and J. Got yourself a nice little cutout of the deer. Now we're going to go back to it and we're going to get the bits that we missed. So for example, this one here and this one. Now I'm going to create myself a background. So if you go to down here and get yourself a solid color, get yourself a black and then put it underneath. If I zoom into this bit here, switch over to the polygonal lasso tool, which is right here. This is a little bit more quicker to use. And pretty much it's the same as the pen tool, but this one doesn't have any points. So you don't have to make any selection until you are at the end of it. Once you've got yourself a nice little selection, you just go back to the first one and connect it up, or you can hold Control and then the icon will pop up and that will connect it up. Then you go back to layer one, press delete. You can press it twice and that deletes a little bit more. Go back to another area, for example here, just quickly get yourself the bit selected, press delete, press Control D to deselect. We're also going to do this bit here. You just want to have a look and correct any white lines. Okay, now you can pretty much hide this one and go back to it. Next up, we're going to make the sky a little bit more darker. So to do this, we're going to go over to the gradient tool right here. If you don't have the gradient tool selected, you can right click on it and it will be right here. It is tied together with the bucket tool. you want to click on this one, and then you want to click on the color at the top. The colors that you're going to set it to is, the first one will be 040812. This is a nice little dark blue. You want to press OK. And then next one, you want to set it to this color right here, which is 677ACE. And that is a lighter color. Once you've done that, you press OK. You want to hold shift, left click, and drag it from the top to the bottom. And then you can let go of shift and then let go of your mouse. Now you want to set this one to multiply, which is right here. And this just makes everything nice and dark. Once you've got yourself a multiply, you pretty much want to also hold control and then click on the thumbnail for your deer. And then you want to click on your layer, which has the background, and then create yourself a mask. Now you want to press control I to invert it, and this will pretty much only apply it to the background. Next up, we're going to get ourselves the shape. To get ourselves a shape, you can either use the shapes right here. You can get the line tool. Now I prefer to use the pen tool. It's a lot quicker. So if you go to the pen tool, you pretty much go over to the top where it says path and set this one to shape. With the shape, you want to make sure that the fill is on none. So you want to disable the fill, and you want to go over to stroke and set this one to a white color. Next up, you want to set this number to 20 pixels. And then once you've set the number, use the little slider over here. And the very last option that you need to change is the line. So if you go over to this option right here and go over to align, you want to set it to the center one. Now that you've aligned it so it's in the center, you can then go ahead and create your shape. So I'm going to click once here. I'm also going to click up here. Might put it a little bit higher, about there. And then one down here, and then back to the first one. I'm then going to put it above so I can actually see the whole shape. Next up, we're going to make our shape glow. To do this, we're going to go into the blending option. So if you right click, go to blending options, you want to get yourself a inner glow, a color overlay, and a outer glow. For the inner glow, you want to set this one to a nice bright orange color. So if you go down here and then press OK, set the opacity to 60, set the mode to normal, and then set the size to 10. Next up, you want to go over to this one and then set the color overlay to a plain white. And the very last one is the outer glow, and you want to set this one to a different effect. The effect that we're going to use is linear dodge add. We're going to change the opacity. So you want to put the opacity to 71, change the size to 59. And if you wanted to, you can give this one a little bit of an orange or any other color that you want. And this will pretty much change the color of your shape. Now I'm going to use a red, and then I'm going to press OK, and that is pretty much done, that step. Now that we've got our shape, all we're going to do is make this bit here be in front of the shape. Now, because we've already cropped it out, all we're going to do now is get yourself the polygonal lasso tool right here. You want to left click and then select the bit right here. You can go just about here and then go back to the first one. You then want to press Control J. Once you've got yourself a copy of it, you pretty much put it on top of the shape. So now it is in front of it. Now, because we cut this image, there is still a few little white areas. So if you wanted to, you can remove them, and it just makes your image that little bit nicer. You don't have to, but it does make a big difference. Now, the only thing is, now that we've got ourselves a copy of it, you also have to delete it on layer 1 and layer 3. So you need to delete it on both. We're also going to hop over to the other side. Go back to layer 1, and then you want to hide the shape. Get yourself a selection. So we're going to go back to the pen tool. Select this horn right here. And then hold control, left click. Once again, press control J. And you can bring the shape back now, and you have it on top of it. Now, because we didn't exactly crop out all of our image, we're going to go back to the background right here. And then you want to use the eraser tool, set it on a soft effect, soft feather. And then you want to pretty much get rid of it. Going to make it a little bit smaller for the end bit. And there we go. That's looking really good. Now it's blended together. Select layer 1 and get yourself a brightness and contrast. Once you've got that, you want to set the brightness on minus 150. You want to hold control and click on the thumbnail for layer 1 and then get yourself a new layer. Now that you've got yourself a new layer, we're going to go over to the brush tool and we're going to create ourselves some fake lights. You want to make sure that the size is on at least 400 and have it on white color. And now that you've done that, just pretty much go over the bits which need some light. This is the bits that reflect off the shape itself. So we're going to need quite a few around like so. Then you want to press Ctrl D, and then you want to go over to the effects and then set this one to overlay. Now that you've done that, you want to press Ctrl J, get yourself another one, and then once again Ctrl J. Then for the very last one, you want to right click on it, go to blending options, and then set this one to color overlay. Set it to a red color, make sure it's on normal, press OK, and then you want to right click on it and then convert smart object. Now that you've done that, you want to set this one to color and then set it to about 35%. The next thing is to correct this little bottom bit which we made. So go to the erase tool, get rid of it on this one, and then also get rid of it on that one as well. You also want to do it on the color, so this message will come up, press OK, and same again with the color. We need to apply it to the horns, so because these are separate and these are on top of the image, we're going to have to first of all combine them together. So if you hold shift and then click on the top one and then convert this into a smart object, so these are together now. You can label this, so horn left and right, so you know what's what. So now that these two are together, you want to also get the eraser tool and then erase this little bit here so it blends. It gets rid of the line and makes it a little bit more invisible. You can also do the same to over here. For example, this bit here and then the under bit. You can zoom back out. So pretty much now all you got to do is do the same as last time and apply it to this bit here. You want to hold control, left click on the thumbnail, and then get yourself a brightness. Turn down the brightness to minus 150. Once again, hold control, click on the thumbnail, get yourself a new layer. In that new layer, you want to get the bucket tool, get yourself a white color, left click on the screen, press Ctrl D. You want to set this one to overlay, and then you want to press Ctrl J, and then press Ctrl J one more time. And then for the last one, you want to right click on it, blending options, go over to color overlay, set this one to normal. Set this one to normal, convert smart object, and then set it to color. Set the opacity to 35. You want to first of all press Ctrl J on the background, go up to filter, go down to blur, and then go to Gaussian blur. Set it to 8 pixels for the radius, and then you want to press OK. Get yourself the eraser tool, make it a little bit bigger. And then just erase this little bit at the bottom here so it blends. Next up, you want to right click on the background, go to blending options, get yourself a inner shadow, and set it to color burn. Have it on a black color. You can leave this on 90. Have the distance on 2, and then have the size on 250. Press OK. If you wanted to, you can brighten the image up a little bit more. So if you go down here, get yourself the eraser tool, and then just brighten this bit here. And that is pretty much it. You can now save it, give it a name, save it as a PSD, press save, press OK, and then also save it as a PNG. And then press OK.